Hey everyone, and welcome back to another lesson of Trash Academy. My name is Eliseo, and in today's lesson, we're going to be talking about hospital waste, just one of the many sectors where we find plastic. What does plastic hospital waste look like? Okay, here in the US and in other parts of the world, there are actually four different types of categorized medical waste: infectious, hazardous, and radioactive plastic waste that comes from bandages, surgeries, and other operations that is heavily regulated and must be incinerated or autoclaved. Now, if you're counting at home, you're probably wondering, well, what's the fourth? Well, the fourth is actually just general waste, which is not contaminated and is treated just like your city's trash, just like the bin you have at home, in the kitchen, your bedroom, or even in the bathroom. Now, talking about plastic hospital waste can sometimes be a little bit problematic, and that's because plastic has been extremely useful in the medical field. But the use of single-use plastics has only dramatically increased due to its accessibility, its ability to prevent infections, and the idea that single-use plastics are actually a lot cheaper than durable medical equipment. Now, the use of single-use plastics has only reduced the need for autoclaving, where tools are sterilized using high heat and high steam in order to be used safely again. Okay, so plastics have completely changed the medical field in recent years, and we have come to see that single-use plastics are used a lot more and discarded a lot more frequently. But the inadequate mismanagement, meaning how we handle all that plastic waste, especially hospital waste, is causing huge problems for our environment. Here in the US, hospital waste is only categorized as infectious and hazardous, and is heavily regulated and has to be incinerated, meaning it has to be burnt, which only creates organic pollutants such as furans and dioxins and are released into the air we all breathe. Now, one thing I want everyone to know is that only 15% of hospital waste, meaning all that plastic trash that comes from hospitals, is actually classified as hazardous, which covers waste that is either radioactive, infectious, or even toxic. And the other 85% of the medical waste is actually not much different than the trash we have in our bin at home. Now, when we're talking about reducing plastic hospital waste, we're talking about that 85% of plastic waste that is non-hazardous, non-toxic, and non-infectious, where we would see the reductions come from. But one thing to know is that in the longer term, there is actually a higher cost, meaning it's more expensive to replace single-use plastic than the other durable equipment.
Plastic pollution is complex, and there's no one quick fix that will solve this issue. Five Gyres is continuing to explore the different sectors to work towards target solutions. And to be successful, we must all work together: policymakers, innovators, corporations, activists, scientists, and individuals. Follow along and join the movement at Five Gyres.
Now I want to thank you all for joining us once again in Trash Academy, and I hope to see you all real soon. Adios.